final to look forward to in North Adelaide against Woodville West Torrens for the first time in SANFL history.
Oh, that was clever. And they combined for a goal.
Well, the boys wants to play on here. He's kicked one of the goals of the afternoon.
Takes it straight out of the rough. Jordan Foote,
the leading goal kicker for the last 3 years.
Jake Komatidjani was concussed the last time they played North in that semi-final, so disappointing that he wasn't able to force his way back into the lineup after playing 13 of the 16 games for the Eagles. But they used 33 players this year, the Eagles, and they all have just been a part of the reserves premiership as well.
And the Eagles, well, they have been knocking on the door for the best part of a decade. They won in 2011, and boy, they've been close on many, many occasions. Finally, they get the chance to get back in and maybe get a little bit of revenge and redemption on that 2018 controversial preliminary final.
In joyful strains and let us sing. Advance Australia Fair.
The toss has been won by the Eagles. They will be heading to the left of screen, and Luke Thompson is one of the players left from that 2011 premiership glory for the
Eagles. This lineup, though, look, it is going to be Harvey v.
Jack Hayes. Yep.
So that's very unusual.
As we get set to go, grand final day, statewide super SANFL, 140th year of the competition, the first ever grand final between North Adelaide and Woodville West Torrens, and we're underway in near perfect conditions.
Great,
and the heat's coming early, as you can see there. That's great stuff. Harvey and Jack Hayes in the ruck. Hayes gets a good run at it. Ball came back to Harvey. Jack Hayes with a tackle, suggestion of being high, zigzagging his way through there. Jordan Foote has created something out of nothing. Well, it's taken 21 and a half minutes, but the Eagles get there first.
Well, well done to Foote on the statewide super replay. Just ripped it out of their hands and just put it on the boot and snapped their first goal. They had to make something out of nothing. They've done that now. That's the settler they needed. Just see the Eagles leading the tackle count earlier. Unfortunately, sometimes I think that's when you're second to the ball. The stat can be misleading.
Here goes Goldsworthy on the left, turns it around. He's got a wonderful goal sense, the 200 gamer.
Watch this contest, statewide super replay. It's a clean take from the veteran. Goldsworthy swings it around on his left boot. As we said, he's a terrific kick pre-game, and he doesn't let his teammates down. They've definitely settled better on this second term.
Well, Goldsworthy's got it again here, and he can drive it high. Oh. Not his best effort, and certainly favoured Carl Finlay, but on the deck, here's the dangerous row. Well, suggestion of a high tackle there. Umpire didn't see it that way, and Hartung now relieves the pressure for North Adelaide.
Have a look at the statewide super replay soon, John. I couldn't see from here, mate, but yeah, I tell you what. They're active, though, the Eagles. They're active.
Rolling around the body, and Jordan Foote works into space and takes a mark well within scoring range. Nick Hayes was calling for it, but Jordan Foote with his back to play. You can see the high fly there was Finlay, but was this a high tackle on James Rowe?
This goes back in. Let's have a look at this tackle. Hard to see from there, so maybe the umpire got it right. But I love this play by the Eagles. That's Foote working overtime, making sure he's pushing forward, pushing back, getting to where the footy is, and that quick kick came in and he was loose.
Two goals last week in the prelim final. Two goals against the Roosters when they met at Prospect in round four. High quality player from 48. Likes it off the boot. Goal umpire doesn't have to move after North kicked the first three of the game. The Eagles have kicked the next three.
A quick kick came in on the statewide super replay. Jordan Foote pushing forward just inside 50 and nails a really important goal. Just see the Eagles settling down a lot better in this second term than they did the first.
Coon in traffic, waited for the option. It came again from Finlay. He's looking for Hinder. Front position, couldn't control the mark. Right there with him, Roland. Cheetahs joins in, strong work at the body and good acceleration out of the congestion as well for Tumpus, who squares it now and finds Sinor. Where Jack Hayes can go short once pull. marks in front of Moore. Out wide wants Lonigan. Keanu Miller came off his man, who's now free. Lonigan just unbalanced. Had to take a moment. Gets it to Goldsworth. He's going to drive long with the left boot. Front position, Lawson. Couldn't complete it. Coming through Tumpus in traffic. Lost the handle. Tried to work it to the advantage of Rowe. Found it nonetheless.
Good answer.
Intelligent handball finds Gus Paul on the boundary line with a banana. Sinks it. Kicks the goal. The Eagles close to within three.
Well, we got a grand final on our hands now. Both teams committing themselves left, right and centre. Loose ball here. You've got to be clean below your knees, and that's what Rowe was. Just snuck that handball out, but how's this for a check side goal to pull? Absolute ripper.
Got Andrew Moore picked out.
But oh, well done. Oh, read that well.
That is a good take by Lonigan. He's been good since he's come back into this side. Just provided some real strength in the midfield for them. Hartung, and the free kick is going to go to the Eagles. Lockie McNeil.
Just a front on contact, they reckon. Free kick there. I've loved Redden starting in the ruck. I didn't like it in the first term when he didn't start in ruck. That worried me. He's gone in there and he's got his hands to plenty.
Oh Gussie Paul!
You're kidding me.
He's just a little man. He's a pocket dynamo and he stretched up all 170 centimetres of himself and plucked that from the sky and he's ready to go back to back.
Oh, that's just sheer desire, isn't it? Man in front read it better. Took a terrific mark. I'll tell you what, he'd be pumped after his last goal. So let's see if he can do the dead in front drop punt, because sometimes that gets all the players.
Here he is. Little Gus Paul. The kick is good and the Eagles are in front.
Have a look at this mark. Statewide super replay. This little fella, what a terrific mark. He's already kicked a miracle goal just a minute ago. Comes in and then kicks the drop punt goal. Sensational stuff. Eagles are just playing a terrific quarter. What about these inside 50s, boys? 11-1 this term. It's a complete flip.
There is no doubt about that. I have not heard Fergus, what's his name, for a long time.
Huge.
And it is.
That's a huge haul.
Well done, Tim. Come on, lock it away. There it
there
is.
It
here
is.
We go. The Eagles go forward now. Here's a chance for Lockie McNeil. Oh, boy. The young man in his first year at footy puts it through.
What a sensational goal in the statewide super replay. Young McNeil coming in here. He made the mistake in the first quarter, just rushed his work, and he's learned from that. And in the second quarter, like the whole team, he settled down and he's nailed the goal. Now, I'm pretty sure, boys, that his father, I reckon, is Tim McNeil, that played for Norwood in the 80s and 90s. I'm going to check that out. I think that's correct.
His foot. Eagles 5-1 since quarter time are all over the Roosters here at the moment. We're on the ropes. Still plenty of time left, obviously. And here's Foot once more, working into
three.
A space.
Three.
He can. He does. Three for the quarter. How about this?
The statewide super replay. Pool involved again, but how's Rowe? You've got to have good hands. That's a second goal assist he's had this term. And Foot, well, he's on fire. He kicked a great goal there first to settle him down in the first quarter. And he's been terrific this quarter with two more.
Eight possessions of this term, three clearances and two goals from Jordan Foote has been just enormous the way he has gone about his football, and you've seen a huge change in momentum.
Very busy, like the rest of the team at the moment, just getting their hands on the footy, just dominating.
High flyer, Finlay couldn't complete the mark, chance for Nick Hayes.
Good kick.
Squeeze it up, wants Bomberto,
can't
reach down low, had to take them on. And that's very good work against the opposition coming from Chalmers.
Very, very good mark. You know you're going to get hit doing that. You have to commit your body in grand finals, and he did exactly that. What about this dominance? It's 60 possessions to 30 so far this term.
We know how good this man is in front of goal as well, Jake Bomberto. 24 goals, 13 goals in 12 of the 15 games he's played this year. Double figures eight times. Off the boot, looks good, is good. They kicked five goals here in 9 minutes. The Eagles, and they're threatening to run away with the grand final.
Well, the Eagles can do no wrong at the moment. They're cleaner, they're sharper, they're more committed, they've settled down. Bomberto, a beautiful kick. It's sensational stuff. I felt North Adelaide just let Eagles off the hook a bit in that first term, and they're paying dearly for it now. There's got to be some regrouping at half time, which they'll want to quickly get to, but I reckon we might have a long quarter, John, with those eight goals scored, isn't it, so far in this term?
High ball, front position, Tanner Smith brought it to ground. Zekley went without it. Here's Poole, being everywhere in this term. McNeil, Tumpus, they share it around. Tumpus forced to kick quickly. Favours Finlay. Going back with the flight, Nick Hayes just disrupted it. Cheetahs around the body. Bounce, not good for Ramsey. Well done, Signor against Wigg. Gave it up to Foot, who jams it onto the boot. He's kicked another. They've got eight for the quarter. Their best ever quarter this season. They are on fire.
Well, the Eagles just keep marching on. Have a look at this. He just gets the little give up. Foot come charging through. His desire this quarter has been outstanding. He's got four goals for the game. The Eagles are absolutely dominating at the moment. 21-1 inside 50s. Amazing stat. 38-20 contested possessions. Have a look at that. Those numbers. That is frightening.
At his second quarter alone, what a remarkable turnaround. And the hands and the strength of Joe Signor to take that ball at the top of the square under all sorts of pressure, bring it down, and then find Foot running
great
past.
Give.
That was just amazing football by the Eagles. 29 points they lead by, and they looked like they were, well, being outclassed. They were lucky to get within those 15 points in that first turn. The only goal they got was that opportunistic one from Foot.
Foot, and you thought to yourself, they just didn't settle well, did they? They were fumbling and not clean, and their senior players weren't quite doing the things they should have been, but wow, they turned it around. Whatever Jade Sheedy said or gave him was great.
Just bottle it, Tim. Here we go again. Oh, Moore. Smith's his target. There's Rowe in the middle of the ground. Chalmers camped out over the top of the footy. And look at the ball thrown up here.
It's been a miserly quarter by the Eagles as far as giving North Adelaide anything. They got the one inside 50 and the one goal. And that's it.
Well, Jordan Foote's had five clearances for the game. He's kicked four goals, had 16 touches. Seven of them are contested. He's taken the ball inside 54 times. He's just on fire, putting on a clinic at the moment, Jordan Foote. Going onto it, Jones. A couple of Eagles go into each other. Leaves
good
it with
tackle.
The boys. Paul, Eagles are out. Here goes Lockie Jones. He's got Tumpus if he needs on the outside. Goes straight down the centre. Goldsworthy stands up against Jarman, and the Eagles will have the ball thrown up here just in their forward pocket. Still a chance to maybe get one more. Jack Hayes with the touch, gives it to Rowe. One of the most dangerous men in the competition in front of the goal. He puts his arms out and sets, oh boy, we've got nine for the
beautiful ruck work, Jack Hayes, straight down the throat of the Ken Farmer medalist, Rowe, and as soon as it hit his hands, he knew it was a goal. Don't worry about that. And they are on a rampage. I don't know if I've seen anything like this in a grand final.
Amazing work. First time this season any team has kicked nine goals in a quarter in the SANFL. Nick Hayes to Poole. And they're away again. Siren in the background. 33 minutes of pure genius from the Woodville West Torrens Eagles, and they have come from 18 points down in the opening quarter to hold a 35-point lead here at the main break. They've kicked 9-1, and at halftime it's the Eagles 10-3, 63, North Adelaide 4-4, 28.
Here's a chance to get the quick early goal, third term.
Just his sixth game in an injury-interrupted season. Kick four in the grand final win in 2018. That's off the mark. He sprayed it from 20 out. Well, they're shell-shocked at the moment.
Oh, that would have been the one, you know, 90 seconds in to get that first goal would have given some real impetus to go forward. But, yeah, that hurts because that's a lot of effort to miss.
Luke Thompson down the wing, big fly from Bomberto. Into the front, here's Lawson. He's got a big strapping on his knee. He damaged the medial ligament a few weeks ago. Here's Bomberto going forward, one-on-one contest. The speed of Goldsworthy, former premiership teammates there. And Jared Allman knew exactly what he was dealing with, didn't he, when he had Goldsworthy and just held him back.
Yeah, there was definite... And that's what happens when you're going inside 50 one-on-one. And you see the way they linked up through the middle with their hands. They did that so well in the second term, the Eagles, and they've just been able to do it once again. And that I can't help but feel that that missed goal, they're going to rue that one, because it really does change momentum and thinking. If Goldsworthy nails this, that is a real big dagger in the heart.
Huge turnaround after that Barnes miss, and we've seen Matty Goldsworthy spending a little more time forward, just carrying a sore thigh. He's already kicked the goal. Oh, here he is. And, gee, that Barnes hurt. Miss really hurts, as Tim said. And the Eagles continue on their merry way.
Well, the Eagles were able to get a forward entry one-on-one statewide super replay. Always causes grief for defenders. And after a miss at the other end for the Roosters, the Eagles go down through the experience of Goldsworthy and shoot that margin out to 40 points.
Tanner Smith there. Wig with a quick kick. Ball punched down. Bold. Foot. Didn't get a kind bounce. LeBoy's taken high. Umpire says free kick going the way of North Adelaide.
Yeah, fair call. Put that in the hole. Took that oncoming traffic.
18 free kicks to 12, North Adelaide.
Oh, that's
hard done. Lowson with the tackle. And here comes the clinical finisher. James Rowe again.
Well, if you want a moment on the statewide super replay that depicts this grand final since quarter time, that was it. Very lethargic effort from North Adelaide allows the Eagles to get an opportunity, and this guy is laser-eyed, Jimmy Rowe. He doesn't miss.
You're right, Tim. Since the 30 years they've been there, they've just challenged in the finals. They have been consistently a wonderful footy club, but they've struggled in finals in the past decade, and this is going to be a really sweet one.
They've found a different look in their midfield, haven't they? And I think Redden made an enormous difference to them, having that big dominant first ruck. But the Hayes brothers have really matured. They've come of age, and Jack especially has had a terrific year and been able to play that sort of backup ruckman, which he loves. The back play just takes mark upon mark, reads it so well, and there's his brother just taking a nice mark in front.
One thing we noticed too for a few years, and the work of Mickey Godden has been fantastic to provide a great foundation, was, you know, they had a couple of those grand finals where Mick Wunke pretty much kicked the majority of their goals.
Yeah, correct.
And they just could not kick, you know, beyond 9 or 10 goals in a grand final. They've got 12 today, and they've done that really well.
And at Ken Farmer medals.
Exactly. And here is a chance now for Sammy Lowson, the boy from Coburg. He's just taken that mark. And today for him, well, he's been a threat because you've always got to put someone on him. And you know that he is dangerous, he's capable. He's kicked just the two behinds. And he's got himself in a bit of trouble with the photographer there. He's going to have a great shot, though, if Sam Lowson can drill it from 40 out on a really tough angle. Oh, he has. That is just a great kick. I want to see that photo.
Whoa.
And he lets him know too.
And the statewide super replay sees Lowson get a bit of reward for his day out, and then it was on straight away. And just tempers getting frayed a bit late in this game, but it's a bit late for the push and the shove, I would have thought. A bit too late for that. And the push and the shove might have been perhaps 5 goals in that second quarter.
Lowson comes their seventh goal kicker.
Eagles are lining up on the boundary line with the coach, Jade Sheedy, and the interchange players ready to run on and celebrate this magnificent premiership that's going down to Oval Avenue. There it is.
And there's the siren. After nearly a decade of heartbreak and a host of finals fumbles, the Eagles fly to the top of the SANFL tree again.
They're going to enjoy this. An incredible moment for all of them. You know, many experienced players, but a lot of kids as well.
We're the mighty Eagles, and we always battle through. The mighty flying Eagles, wearing gold and green and blue. Sound the siren, turn us loose, and watch the feathers fly, and you see what we can do. We're the mighty flying Eagles. We're the mighty flying Eagles.
And the winner of the 2020 Jack Oatey Medal is, from the Eagles, Jordan Foote.
Obviously a great honour to accept this award, but we play a team game and team success is what you want, and we got that today, so couldn't be happier with our boys. Thank you to North Adelaide, giving us a good contest. Let's enjoy this, boys.
Congratulations, Jordan. Thank you, Marina. The fourth generation Eagle, what a story it is, after his father David was involved with the club as well. And likewise, his grandfather John and his great-grandfather Edwin, who played for the Eagles back in 1920s and 30s as well. Coach Jade Sheedy and the captain, Lukey Thompson, ladies and gentlemen, your premiers are Woodville West Torrens Eagles.
And watch the feathers fly, and you'll see what we can do. We're the mighty flying eagles. We're the mighty flying eagles. We're the mighty flying eagles in gold and green and blue. We're the mighty flying eagles. We're the mighty flying eagles. We're the mighty flying eagles.
SANFL SANFL champions, the Woodville West Torrens Football Club.
Thanks, Lowe.